No. He got excited all on his own.
On his own, on his own.
Oh, I meant to tell you.
What?
Allegoric theory is correct.
Which one?
The one to do with reflections. In the mirror was enough.
Explain yourself more clearly.
I was in front of a mirror, sitting on the edge of the bed, and I was alone. Yet he was by my side, but nothing from him. No reflection, nothing. Blank.
Not even his clothes.
Not even his shirt.
I'd love to have seen that.
One doesn't see a thing.
You found something to eat?
I? No.
There is a smell of garlic sausage. I'm not hibernating. You don't seem very pleased.
I am surprised.
Keep your surprise for later on. You'll need it. You didn't foresee this in your second volume, Still at the Printers. It will be my pleasure to fill in the gaps in your learning when you attain my spiritual level. We shall then have the long winter evenings before us for our discussions. The long evenings of many winters. Your young assistant will make an excellent companion for my son. He's already quite fond of him. He's told me so. He's a gentle, sensitive youth. In the course of the centuries, they will learn to know each other better, just as we shall. As brooks flow into streams, streams into rivers, and the rivers into the sea, so our adepts flow back to us and swell our ranks. Soon we shall be victorious and triumphant. We shall then hold sway over this earth, which awaits our coming as autumn awaits winter. Look at him, almost an old man, with his flabby stomach and spindly legs, springing with dog-like devotion a fresh adept who only a few nights ago was under his protection. Look well at this man, who secreted another girl more closely than a miser hoarding his gold. But tonight he's happy. See how he frisks and capers. I must leave you now. See you later, gentlemen. Meditate while awaiting your turn, for it would be extremely difficult for you to get away from here, unless, of course, you have wings. Like a bat.